Matt Moscona joining us from ESPN 104.5 there in Baton Rouge, the simulcast on New Orleans. And I won't try to even duplicate that plug that Matt gave us a few minutes ago for the 90,000-watt giant.
The 90,000-watt flame-throwing giant blanketing the Crescent City with sports talk goodness.
BYU, not necessarily a giant in the Power Five, but a formidable opponent that wins eight or nine games against what I always term as the oddest schedule in college football because they load up with as many difficult opponents as they can. But when everybody else dives into conference play, they're searching around for, they played Wagner in November last year. You know, they're playing Michigan State and playing all these Pac-12 schools early on, and then they're just scraping together a schedule late. But they've got LSU in week one in Houston. And yeah, a lot of people around college football with the bigger matchups, Michigan, Florida, Alabama, Florida State in particular, are going to disregard this game as an LSU. Okay, BYU's, they're scrappy, but this thing's going to get out of hand in the second half. Not asking for a prediction, but it sounds like you feel a closer game than that.
I just look at BYU and I see a roster that's made up of a lot of guys that at some point go on their LDS mission. So you have a team that just biologically is older, not just in classification, but guys that instead of 18, 19, 20 are 22, 23, 24. So you have more physically mature players. LSU will have more talent and more star ratings by their recruits and all that stuff. But BYU is just going to have an older, physically more mature team. And they typically play a very disciplined brand of football. And last year, BYU lost four games by a combined 8 points. They didn't get blown out of any game. They showed more than able to compete with some of the better teams on their schedule. Something else to keep in mind with BYU is they actually do play a week before the LSU game. So they will have a tune-up of sorts before they head to Houston. So while LSU will be debuting a new offense and a whole lot of new starters, BYU will have a game before they take the field in Houston.
Unfortunately for the Cougars, a couple injuries. If you can update us, a linebacker and also a defensive back.
Yeah, BYU returned just six starters from their defense a year ago, and they opened camp, and one of their starting cornerbacks, McChesney, tore his ACL. He's lost for the year. And then just Thursday, kind of an odd situation, returning junior starting linebacker Francis Bernard announced that he's taking a redshirt season for personal reasons. This was a guy who had 80 tackles last year. He started every game. He was third on the team in tackles. Had 5.5 tackles for loss, a couple of sacks, 3 interceptions. So he filled up the stat sheet, and that was a starting outside linebacker for BYU a season ago who won't be there for them this year. So a defense that returned only six starters now, you know, a couple of weeks into fall camp is down two more.
Matt Moscona from ESPN 104.5 there in Baton Rouge. Also catch it on ESPN New Orleans. Nice enough to drop by here on a regular basis to catch us up on LSU football because, Matt, whether they go 8-4, 7-5, whatever the record is, if we're looking at the negative side, I got to keep track of LSU. So you have been by far the best guy to help me do that.
Always happy to come on, Mark. I appreciate the invite.